Today I'm going to talk about metabolic energy demand and food utilization of the hydrothermal vent curve, from now on, I will call the vent curve X curve in brief. Okay, let's go to the introduction. What is the X curve? It is the Greater Island, and under the surface of the sea, there are many hydrothermal vents. And near the X-curve, and they live in less than 200 meters, and they go 8 to 20 meters. And the environment, they are sulfur rich, high water temperature, and low pH, and full of trace elements, like iron, copper, and so on, and there are many gas, like carbon dioxide, nitrogen, O2, they are all from the vent. And what is the expert eat? They are zooplankton, look like this, and they will kill by the toxic discharge from the vent. They will boil down and eat by the crab. But the food supply is discontinuous and poor. So when there are sufficient food, they will eat. But when lack of food, they will consume their stored lipid. And our purpose is to know about nutritional adaptation of extract and the relationship between energetic demand and digestive enzymes, and to address the effect of energy storage and trophic preference. And so to the material and metal. This is central of crab. We got 200 of crab in a whole meal because we want to avoid the sexual difference. And we'll put them into a natural seawater and give them 2 hours of light and 2 hours of dark every day. And the first day of the experiment, we got 20 specimens, cut down their pickup gland, and 10 for lipid analysis, and 10 for enzyme assess. We will do every 10 days, and total we have 30 days. What we will check? We will check respiration measurement because we want to know the oxygen consumption. And we will see the lipid and fatty acid, and because we want to know how do the expert consume when no food, and we will check the enzyme if this is the most important because we want to know how their enzyme active in the low pH and high temperature. Let's go to our result. And the respiration measurement. The X axis is temperature and the Y axis is oxygen consumption. As we can see, the higher temperature they go and the higher oxygen consumption they will. And this is the lipid content composition. This is the first day of the experiment, and this is 30 days. As you can see, the first day is more higher than the 30 days of total lipids. But there are many kind of lipids. There are some go up, but some go down. So there is a there were no significant statistical. And this is epizine enzyme assess. Epizine assess is a function to check the activity of the enzyme. There are many enzymes in expert body, and almost all of them have activity, but there are two special special enzymes. Like this one is will have high activity in high pH, but the least one will have a high activity in low pH. 'Cause the two enzymes, we can know the expert has wide endurance level about the pH. We can change the lipid into fatty acid, and this one we mean into to express the sugar. This is the first. The S acid is the starvation period. Y axis is activity. The first day we say that 100%, and when the day goes on, they will decrease. Two of the enzymes are all decreased. and temperature effect of the two enzymes. We can see when the 50 degrees Celsius and 60 degrees Celsius, they have both the highest activity. But in different degrees Celsius, the two enzymes have that have different effect, like this. When 6 degrees Celsius, the trypsin is higher activity, but the chemotrypsin is decreasing. But when when 70 degrees Celsius, both of them are decreased. Then the pH effect on trypsin and chemotrypsin. We can see when pH is 4 to 10, they are all have higher activity. Oh, by the way, the X axis is pH and the Y axis is activity. Trypsin and chemotrypsin. We can see many ion affect the enzyme, and as we can see, the copper chloride and ferric chloride have inhibition by these two ions. Sorry, any discussion? The lipid core, they are more than 50% of lipid are stored in microglia. And the second one, lipid is important for surviving without food, because when they don't have food, they will consume their lipids. And the lipids in their microglia gland, they can use the microglia gland more than 30 days, because in this experiment, we don't have any crabs who are dying for starving. And also, also, as a pilot program. hydrogen or carbon hydrogen. And the BTS composition, we have MUFA, SFA, and PUFA. And the monounsaturated fatty acid is mainly composition of expert fatty acid. And digestive potential expert pretendiasis show a significantly elevated thermal tolerance, but the trypsin, both trypsin and chemotrypsin of expert show a wide range of the stability from slightly acid and alkaline to condition. High tolerance against metal ions, which is an advantage for the functioning of this enzyme in the vicinity of hydrothermal vents, because the environment has many iron ions. The conclusion: expert exhibit physiological adaptation to the dead body inhabited in a highly challenging environment. Fatty acid in meat gargling is important when food shortage. Enzyme in expert has high endurance level in high level of environment. Thanks for attention.
Okay. We have a minute to close the presentation. So now one minute discussion.